Now, if you're having a problem with your iPhone and you can't figure out, one of the last things that you may need to do is reset it. We can reset the entire iPhone, or what we can do is reset something like the network or your home screen options. Let's take a look at resetting our iPhone. By the way, this is also where we set it up to transfer to a new iPhone. Now, if you find this video helpful, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. Let's take a look at resetting our iPhone. Let's go over to my iPhone. Now, the first thing I recommend doing before we go into our reset options is to make sure that you have a recent backup. So how do we do that? Well, we just go into our Settings app, and then we go to our Apple account, formerly known as the Apple ID, and under Apple account, you're going to see iCloud. I tap on iCloud, and then when I swipe up, what you're going to see here is iCloud backup. Now we can see that this was backed up an hour ago, but let's just say that it hasn't been backed up in a while. All I do is just tap on it, and then I say backup now. Once it is done backing up, then what we can do is we can reset it. So it's always good to have a recent backup. So that's how we can have a recent backup. So I have a recent backup. Now what I'd like to do is reset it. Well, in order to do that, we need to go back to our settings. So I tap on iCloud up here, and then we go back, and we go back one more time to our settings. We need to go to our settings. Specifically, what we need to do is go over to our general settings. When we're looking at our general settings, down at the very bottom, you're going to see transfer and reset iPhone. As I mentioned in the introduction, this is also where we set up our iPhone to transfer to a new iPhone. So if you're getting a new iPhone, this is where you need to go. Just follow the instructions. Let's go ahead and tap on it. Just follow the instructions to prepare for a new iPhone. Now, what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to resolve an issue. I'm not transferring this over to a new iPhone. So what I need to do is I need to go down towards the bottom here. And you're going to see we have two options, reset as well as erase all content and settings. Well, I don't want to go into erase all content and settings, not yet. What I would recommend doing is going into reset here first. And when I tap on reset, we're able to select what we want to reset. So if it's an issue with the network, try resetting all your network settings. You're going to have to enter in your passwords for any Wi-Fi networks. It's going to erase all those settings, but it might be a little bit easier than erasing the whole iPhone. So you can reset the network settings. Or let's just say you're having a problem with handwriting. You can reset your handwriting style. Or you're having a problem with your home screen layout. You want to start over. Maybe you made a mess of it. I've done that before. Well, you can go and reset it and then start over. So these are all the different reset options that we have. In addition to that, what we can do is reset all the settings. When we tap on this, it's going to erase or reset all of these at the same time. But it is not going to erase your iPhone. So all of your data is going to be there. It's just that your home screen layout will be reset, your handwriting will be reset, your network settings will be reset. You'll have to enter in passwords. But all of your data is still going to be there. So it's going to reset all the settings, but not necessarily erase your iPhone. So that's how you can reset your iPhone. Now, another thing you can do is erase the iPhone. I'm going to tap on cancel down here. Let's say none of that worked. Well, then what you can do is you can erase all content and settings. When you tap on this, what it'll do is it'll erase the iPhone. So all I have to do is just tap on continue here. I'm not going to do it, but I would just tap on continue here, and then it'll erase the iPhone. So how do I get my data back? Well, remember that backup that we made? When it erases the iPhone, one of the first things it's going to ask you is, do you want to restore from a backup? You enter in your Apple account information, and then you select your backup. And that's all you have to do. So that's why it's always a good idea to back it up. Back it up before you reset anything. And then from here, what you're able to do, if you need to reset everything and erase everything, you can go and restore that backup. So that's how we reset all of our settings on the iPhone, including erasing it, and, by the way, how we can prepare for a new iPhone. This is all done in the Settings app under General, and then you go to Reset. Tap on Reset to reset individual settings, and then tap on Erase All to erase your iPhone. Make sure that you have a backup before you do any of this, though. So that's how we reset as well as erase our iPhone. Now, if you found this video helpful, you may want to like it. You can share it with your friends and family. You can also subscribe to my channel. You also may want to check out danstutorials.com. In addition to having more videos, I also have an AI assistant modeled after an Apple genius, and I host classes and webinars on a regular basis. So how can you help support my efforts? Well, it is a membership-based site. So when you become a member, not only do you get access to that AI assistant, but you also have access to my classes and webinars. And I take out all of the ads from the videos, so you're not going to see any of those pesky ads in the videos. And then last, you're also helping support a small business. It is just me. I'm not part of some large organization. So when you become a member, you are directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out Dan's Tutorials for more information or danstutorials.com for more information. And thanks for watching.